I think maybe we can transition into some of the part of the banking conversation too, because knowing, you know, that you have intentionally wanted to instill your culture and heritage in your kids and make sure they feel confident to pass that on and also pursue education and the things that are going to help set them up for success later in life. What does it mean for you and your background to be a Latina leader in banking?
Coming from where I came from a town where it's a lot of agriculture, people that are not very educated, having somebody that's in banking that you can trust because you know that it's the right thing for them. You're not doing them because it benefits you. You're really listening to their needs and asking them questions to help them. As a culture, we're very trusting once we find somebody that we can trust, and they build the following, you know, they recommend. So that's very important to me, my word, the fact that they trust me and I want to do something better for them. And then empowering other people to do the same thing, you know, do the career. This is not what I wanted to do. I wanted to be a journalist when I went to college. And I started this as a part-time for me to be able to pay for college. But I ended up staying because I can see the impact that I can make on other people, not just customers, but also, you know, employees. I could be somebody else's mentor. So for me, banking has been a gateway to help not only, you know, Hispanic people, but anyone that wants to look up to you and say, okay, I want to be like her. She's trustworthy. She does what she says she's going to do. And she's going to help me reach my goals, whichever they be, own a house, business, whatever it is. And that is important to me to instill to everybody that I work with.
So it sounds like what you're saying is representation matters.
Yes.
When your community can see someone they can identify with because they have a similar background or shared culture or heritage, that allows them to get access to resources and services that they maybe wouldn't otherwise have tried to access if it weren't for having someone they could trust available to them.
Yep, exactly. Especially if you speak the language, it helps a lot more,
I'm told. Maybe one day I'll get there. Alma, how about you? What does it mean to you to be a Latina in banking? And what has your experience been like in your career?
The similarities, I was listening to Sandy share her story, and the similarities are amazing, because I went to the University of Arizona. My intent was to become an attorney. I really wanted to be a lawyer because I thought I could really make a difference. And the same thing happened. I started working at the bank, and all of a sudden, I really enjoyed it. I enjoyed dealing with different people every single day and trying to see how could I assist them, not only to take care of their current financial needs. You know, people come in typically to the bank because they have a need, but in developing that relationship to try to see what I could do to help them, not only now, but in the future. And before you knew it, I had a 40-year career in banking, right? And some days I should have gone to law school. I should have done this, but no regrets, because it's been a very fulfilling experience. One of the things that I love about the opportunities that the banking industry has given me are the opportunities to mentor others, to really help people understand that it is a process. It is not a one and done. In order to help those that are going to come after us, right, to do perhaps a better job than we are able to do, to take care of our customers, take care of each other, take care of our peers. I think that's very, very important. And I'm proud of the fact that during my career in banking, I have mentored so many people, so many individuals that have flown, if you will, and have achieved great success in the banking industry. And I consider that a feather in my cap.